Hey guys, so I wanted to talk about who the main character of Zombies is. Now, you'd think like, oh, when you're talking about a main character, you obviously include the playable group of the map. But looking at it from a story sense, like let's say you were just reading this in a novel, I think it's quite clear that Richtofen would have to be the main character, even being more important or more central than Samantha and Dr. Maxis themselves. So why do I say Richtofen is the main character? Well, I mean, obviously he's tied to the story pretty heavily. He's literally involved in every single map released so far, except for Mob of the Dead. But even then, we know after Zetsubou no Shima, we know Richtofen went to Alcatraz and even paid them a visit and, you know, somehow acquired their blood. So he's involved with Mob of the Dead pretty much. Now you're probably asking, he's not really involved in 5, and not in a direct sense, but there's a picture of him on the wall in the war room, the president's room. And I find that really weird, because that kind of gives the idea of like, oh, these guys look up to this man. They see him as an important figure. And while that is probably the weakest map he has a connection with, there is a form of connection there. Of course, it's not just map appearances, but the story itself. You know, the original Richtofen was part of Group 935. Evidently, he caused the main events of the story, you know, by teleporting Dr. Maxis and Samantha away. He evidently caused her to get onto the moon and the MPD and then send the zombies everywhere and all that. He then goes on his quest with the other characters, collecting items along the way, and even when he leaves them and gets into the NPD, the story still stays around him. It still focuses on him as being the announcer, and him directing another group to do what he wants. He's seemingly a main character in the comics, not once, but twice. We're assuming that Origins Richtofen is talking to Samuel, because he's on the front cover, but a zombified version, but then you've got the old Richtofen, you know, being seemingly the antagonist, the main bad zombie guy. And then, of course, we go on to Origins Richtofen. He was part of the group that opened up the gateway for Samantha in Origins, and then ultimately that resulted in the Black Ops 3 story pretty much. Just like his original self, he's the one that knows what he's doing. The others, you know, are pretty much following his word again. He's taken them to certain places to grab each character's soul, and then he came up with the Blood Vial plan. So being part of these story actions, of course, it does make him the main character again. But finally, it's not also just the story or the amount of time you've appeared, it's also about character development. Now in game, the original Richtofen more or less never really changed, to be honest. But what is though, is when we listen to the DeRecent Moon radios, and we hear how Richtofen is before he touches the MPD, and then what he's like playable in game. You know, he's the World at War bias says he's still like a psycho sadist and all that. But he's a lot more reserved. He sounded like the Origins Richtofen, with his kind of low, not as crazy voice. It was subdued, and you know, when you listen to those radios, you think that Maxis is honestly a cunt, because you know, the way he speaks to Richtofen and that, and it's like, no wonder he teleported you, mate. So he does have a little character development there, but it's the Origins Richtofen that's the main meat and bones of what I'm talking about. He's like a son to Maxis in Origins, and you know, he's trying to fit in with the boys at Group 935, who Maxis isn't really liking that much, but then sickness strikes, so Richtofen has to preserve his brain. And throughout the map, while we're doing the egg, you know, he doesn't believe Samantha. He doesn't like her. You know, he always says like, oh, I don't believe you, Samantha, you're a liar and all that. I know what you really are. And it's such a vast difference from there to the Giant, more than any other character. Obviously, he's in the know. Been told by Maxis and evidently Dr. Monty, like, hey, get these souls or whatever. But he also has this secret plan with Maxis about getting the blood vials. And initially, he only wanted the blood vials for himself. He wasn't going to share them with the other three. But it's after Takeo kills himself, and I think he admitted this in Garrod Crovy. That's when he decided, hey, I want these guys to be safe as well. I want them to survive and not disappear. And so it's through that we see that Origins Richtofen actually starts to care about the other characters. And it's a bit amazing compared to his original self, where he hated Dempsey so much and all that and the others. And then in this one, you know, and you can tell by the trailers of that, they're trying to like push together that like, oh, they care for each other. But it's with that moment that you can actually see that Richtofen cares enough that he wants them to not vanish or disappear from existence. And then in some Revelations quotes and even the Richtofen Memories trailer, we can see there's a certain sadness to him. And I guess that's like that with all the characters. I mean, especially Nikolai, there's like a certain depression, sadness to him. But Richtofen's is a bit unique. I think he expresses, you know, no regret for having done what he's done. But there's a sadness to his voice, and I think in Revelations, when he goes to Alcatraz, he talks about missing Sammy, which I think is referring to Stillinger. So it kind of suggests that, like, oh, he did something or something happened. And I think this is backed up with the comic, that opening quote. So we can see that this Richtofen has a fair bit going on with him. Maybe not as much as, like, other video game characters or story characters or whatever, but there's a definite character development with him, and it's pretty surprising in contrast with his original character. And so that's why I say he's the main character throughout the story, and it'll be interesting to see whether he will continue to be in the next game. I mean, they said they were going to end the story, and there may be some connections here or there, but they may not even want to kind of follow what he's done. They may start their own story, and it may have nothing to do with Richtofen at all. But yeah, guys, I talked for a long while. It's interesting to talk about who the main character could be, just going through all the motions. So it's, you know, it's the amount of time they've appeared, their direct affiliation with the story, and character development. I think that's all what can make a main character. But do you agree? Do you think Richtofen is the main character, or do you think it's someone else? Let me know, and I'll catch you guys later. Cheers.